that everything's taken care of for them.
When Dr. Craig Mohnacky opened Mohnacky Animal Hospitals in Carlsbad, he saw a lot of service members.
I've been in the area practicing for 36 years. We saw the need.
When young active duty troops would come in without much money, he couldn't help but do routine procedures for free. He was soon helping spouses and vets as well.
We had a military member that had post-traumatic stress disorder, very anxious, very concerned. And we just felt so good that we could appease the anxiety by making sure that he knew that we were going to help him no matter what.
They did more and more surgeries. In 2013, he officially launched the Helping Paws program. And while owners pay for what they can, they've performed around 2,000 procedures, most at no cost.
Not much better than that, I'd say. Helping vets by helping their pets. And it is a group called Helping Paws. It is dedicated to giving back to our courageous veterans, service members, and it provides low and no cost veterinary care. And so far already, they've helped over 2,500 military families and counting. The new executive director joins us now. Her name is Hannah Mullins, Helping Paws Foundation, and that's helpingpawssandiego.com, the website right now. Welcome, Hannah. Thanks for being here.
Thank you so much for having us. It's an honor.
You bet. It is such a neat thing to do because pets can help anybody, and they are so well known for being, you know, I mean, therapy dogs, it's a phrase for a reason. And our veterans and military, they need it so much. And so it's nice to think that we can help by supporting you and what you're doing. So can you tell us a little bit about Paws?
Well, it is a wonderful organization. I actually had a long career in news. I was a military reporter in San Diego most recently, and I did that story that you just saw about Helping Paws and met the founder, Dr. Craig Mohnacky, and I learned that all too often, troops who are willing to pay the ultimate price can't pay their veterinary bills and face having to give them up or put them down. And the mission to keep them united just grabbed hold of my heart. And so I recently left TV news and joined their efforts.
That's so great. So when did you first hear about Dr. Craig?
That was a couple years ago. I did that story and there's a follow-up story. And I just said, this is what I need to do. And he's been practicing veterinary care for 38 years, and so he had to do something, and I had to join him.
I know, it's so funny because animal people, that's what we're like. You can't help, but it just pulls my heartstrings because I can just see his heart and your heart. So thank you so much for what you're doing. So tell us about this mission. What exactly does your group do?
So we do keep military families united with their pets. They'll come in fearing they're going to have to give them up, as I mentioned, and so we step in and take care of the cost, that financial burden that they can't afford. Vet bills are expensive, and they can add up quickly. It was just a couple weeks ago, we had a dog come in, and it wasn't just a dog, it was a service dog, and so of course right then you have to help.
Exactly.
Then his daughter, the veteran's daughter, 13, said, "We're having money trouble." So of course, they're going to help then. Come to find out, she's talking for him because he had been shot in the head in Iraq. Aww. That family's given so much. They shouldn't have to worry about money troubles. So we step in and take care of a $500 bill, and it's an honor to do that.
It's so neat to think about the hundreds of thousands of people who have gone overseas or even stateside, have given so much, their families, and to think this is one thing that we as civilians can do to help out. Talking to Hannah Mullins, she is with the Paws Foundation, and the website, I want to tell you again, helpingpawssandiego.com, located in Southern California right now, but they are branching out. Want to make sure you know where to go in case you want to help out with such a worthy cause. So you've probably seen a lot of lives changed so far, Hannah.
Absolutely, and it is powerful to see the impact. It really is. This last week, we had a homeless Army veteran come in terrified he would have to put his dog Sammy down. Oh. And he was shaking when the vet tech took the dog to the back because it was such intense separation anxiety. They've really relied on each other and helps him with his anxiety, that having that dog. And so we can be there to make sure that the dog's taken care of, and that was $600 that bill, and just take care of it. But seeing that it can truly be life-changing for some of these veterans and families.
Yeah, so many of them have moved so many times. Mm-hmm. They have little ones to take care of, and paycheck to paycheck's a reality for a lot of people, whether you're military or not. Mm-hmm. So getting a few hundred dollars or a few thousand dollars to help out with the vet bill so they can keep those families intact is pretty amazing. How do they go about, do they go to your website to fill out a form? They call you?
They do. They go to the website. They can call us. All the information's on the website, on our Facebook page. You just look up Helping Paws Foundation. You can find it. Any way they need to contact us, we'll answer and we'll be there to do everything we possibly can.
Yeah, and you've got a very nice Facebook page I saw, and you've got some brochures with your little doggy, huh?
Oh yes, that's my little girl, Miss Charlotte. She's my baby. She's actually quite the tank now. She's grown quite a bit, but she does model very well for us.
Yeah, they're on the little flyers there. What a good girl. And even on your Facebook page too, which we just saw, I know that I saw a campaign right there where you can go to your Facebook page right now, mm-hmm. click on, and you've got a specific dog you're raising money mm-hmm. for, and you can just, is it GoFundMe? Is that one of those?
Well, it's through the charitable giving on their website, and that's actually Sammy, who I just referenced, put that together yesterday, just put some video to show people, you know, they see these faces of the troops, the veterans, and the dogs that need help, and how can you say no?
You can't yeah. at all. So I want to make sure people know how to get a hold mm-hmm. of you. And also, you've got some great, besides Dr. Craig, yeah. that we want to give a shout out, you've got some great partners that are helping you out.
We really do, and the military community is amazing about coming together and forming partnerships and synergies. Cammies and Canine Sanctuary is actually the reason we're here today,
and
they're amazing.
Once you're involved with one group, the rest, you
yes.
just are so all overshadowing each other, but coming
yeah,
together
yeah.
and making those great partnerships, and it's really neat to see.
Absolutely, and another one, Dirty Paws, just cute accessories for dogs. They just recently said, we're going to give you 10% of all of our proceeds because of what you do. And so just those amazing partnerships, the Wounded Marine Fund, you name it. Oh, yeah, that's it. Those are
beautiful
great
accessories.
Little items.
Cammies and canines, like
Absolutely.
We were talking about, Jason, you're right. We've got about 30, 40 seconds, but I want to know, you're putting a call out across America, too, because you want this to go far and wide.
We do, and that's what's so exciting. I think we're really on the brink of that happening, and we've done all the legwork for the nonprofit, and it's been a lot of work,
Aww.
But it's been a success, and now we want to inspire other veterinarians so we can help military pets across America. And that's a very real possibility, and all we need is anyone to reach out to let us know they too want to help military pets.
It's a great cause, and again, you're sitting at home and wondering how you can help. It is Military Appreciation Month, and Hannah mm-hmm. Mullins, Executive Director, and want to tell you the website again, so you can go there right now or make a note of it, and it is helpingpawssandiego.com. It is sort of located in San Diego, Southern California area right now, but they're branching out. So if you can help out or if you need help, please contact Hannah through this website. Hannah, thank you for all you're doing. Keep us posted, okay?
Thank you so much.
You bet. We're back after this on America Trends.